I'm Callie Lewis. You're watching Geek Brief TV. I'm away at my big sister's wedding this week, and on today's brief, I'm doing something that I've wanted to do since we started in December of 2005. First, a little history for those of you who are new. We started Geek Brief with the intention of quitting our day job and doing the show full time. We never focused on a goal with more intensity in our lives, but we were inspired by Don and Drew from The Don and Drew Show and Madge Weinstein from Yeast Radio. We listened to their shows as they closed the door on what we started calling the tyranny of the day job. We wanted to do the same thing. Pod Show and a few great sponsors made it possible. We started by spending about $10,000 on equipment. At the same time, we were working really hard to be debt-free, so we went on a ramen noodle diet so we could quickly pay off the equipment. A package of ramen cost about 10 cents, so it didn't take too long. It's become a cool part of the history of the show, so I wanted to share our recipe. Now, we're very, very, very particular about our ramen noodles. For us, there's only one brand, one flavor, and one way to prepare it. Neil perfected the method in college, and when he introduced it to me, ramen noodles became one of my favorite comfort foods. The brand is Maruchan Ramen, and the flavor is creamy chicken. There are no substitutions that compare, not even close. We're also pretty strict about the type of bowl. The soup actually cooks in the bowl, and it'll taste different if you use a different kind of bowl. Not necessarily bad different, just different. We got ours at Pier 1 Imports. You can also get the right size and shape at Target. Start by opening the package and put the block of ramen into the bowl. Then take the seasoning packet, pour it onto the bowl. Onto the block. And I like to shake the noodles around a little bit to get the seasoning into the nooks and crannies. All right. Pour exactly one cup of water into a pan, and this is very, very, very important. Put it on high heat, but don't let it boil. This recipe was perfected in a coffee pot, so you want to reach about 175 degrees. Look for the first signs of little bubbles, give it a quick stir, and it's ready to pour. Timing is critical. Pretend you're doing surgery. Pour the water in so that the water reaches the level of the ramen noodle brick. Oh, we boiled a little too much. Then dig in immediately. Oh, there we go. Keep the crunch intact, crunch. Now, the noodles will soften up as you finish the soup, but it's the very first few crunchy bites that are the best. Every other way I've ever had ramen noodles, I just think, that was okay. This way makes the noodles something I'd choose to eat anytime, any day. Our diet had a downside though, so I have to issue a warning. Ramen noodles are high in fat, carbs, and sodium. We gained weight on the diet, and Neil's blood pressure increased to the point he had to go on medication for a while. So it's best to enjoy the recipe in moderation. I'm Callie Lewis. Thanks for watching, and thanks for using my promo codes at GoDaddy.com so we can actually afford healthier food now. Thanks. See you next time. Thanks for watching and using my promo codes at GoDaddy.com. Sorry, GoDaddy. I don't do the whole mouth thing as good as the people on TV. It's just flying everywhere.
Another Pod Show video podcast. Stick it on your screen.